Get ready to match the stars. Dick Martin. Brett Summers. Gary Berghoff. Marianne Mobley. Richard Dawson. And Patty Deutsch. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75.
And to think we lost India. What's shaking you, hamburger?
You look very smart.
Thank you.
I love you.
We're a lovely group, aren't we?
Blue.
Aren't we beautiful people? Yes. Each and every one of us.
I love your entrance.
Thank you.
Dramatic.
Thanks.
Terrific.
Very dramatic. Ham bone style. Are you ready?
No.
No. Well, we're going to start without you. Let's say hello to our two players, Susan Copperthwaite and Cliff Goodrich.
Susan, you turn a champion, that's $600, right?
Right.
And she's got her lucky rabbit's foot, and she's being challenged by Cliff, who's had his first and second round question. He has won. You need one to tie, two to win. You ready for that?
Yeah. Let's
okay,
do it.
We'll do it right after this. Now, we'll push this button, reveal the second round question we have for Susan, which reads as follows.
Uh-huh.
Jane said to the psychiatrist,
uh-huh.
She said, Doctor, my husband has this terrible problem. All day long, he keeps going up and down, up and down, up and down. He thinks he's a blank.
I want to ask you something.
Yes. All day long,
are
he keeps going up and down.
Are you trying to ruin my career or something?
Up and down, up and down.
You're going to get me in trouble with my family, you know that?
So he thinks he's a blank,
yes.
That's a very simple, easy one.
Oh, that's a good one, yes.
It's
Isn't
very
that a gooder, Dick?
I think so. I
yes.
think,
I think
a
it's a very snappy, easy. Mm. And I love you in red. I go crazy when I see you with just a touch of red.
Try and control yourself. I know your libido is aroused and all that.
Have you made the reservation?
Yes, I have. Okay, everybody ready over there? Patty is now just finishing, and we call on Susan.
She's all through, is what you...
Jane said to the psychiatrist, Doctor, my husband has this terrible problem. All day long, he keeps going up and down, up and down, up and down. He thinks he's a...
Yo-yo.
Yo-yo. She said her husband thinks he's a yo-yo. Isn't that crazy?
I'd like to see Dickie's first one he threw down there.
No. Well, sometimes he's allowed to change his mind.
I see. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, I'm afraid I missed yo-yo. I said elevator.
Elevator. Yeah. Yeah. Yo-yo and elevator were the two good ones that were in my head. What was in your head, if anything?
Well, there was a lot of air.
Come on,
going
the
through
answer
it.
There.
Well, good gravy, I said elevator.
Four times now.
Two elevators, Susan. Well, now yo-yo wasn't bad. It may happen
it
yet. Don't
nice.
Give up hope. Gary?
Good gravy. I'm sorry. I said seesaw.
Seesaw.
Down, up, and down.
That's that two for the seesaw. Two elevators and one seesaw. So far, no yo-yo is what she is looking for. Up and down, he thinks he's a yo-yo is what she said. What do you say, chic lady?
Oh, thank you. Well, I think yo-yo is a terrific idea.
Good answer, yeah.
But I wasn't that clever.
Oh.
I said elevator.
Elevator. Three elevators and a seesaw. What do you offer?
2 weeks in sunny California. We haven't matched, have we? I've decided
what?
To change this.
Yo-yo! Now. Give that girl another yo-yo and she'll win a game. What do you give that girl?
I'll give her another yo-yo.
That
There's another 100 for you.
All right. Okay. You're excited, right? You what?
I popped my zipper.
She said she popped her zipper.
I have a needle and thread in the dressing room.
You have a needle and thread in the dressing room.
I'll get to it right away.
You want to put it together while I stand there in front of you like this there? Okay.
Well, no. Stop looking, Jane.
Your eyes open.
Huh? Wrong. Are you all right now?
I'm done. Fine.
Okay, fine. All right. Just don't breathe so hard. You'll be all right. Cliff, I'm sorry to see you go. Good luck to you. It was a pleasure meeting you, and we've got a gift for you together with our thanks for
being. I enjoyed it. Thank you.
Thank you, Cliff Goodrich. Okay. Now, you've been here before, Susan. You know how it goes, so we might as well get right to it.
Let's do it.
Okay, let's do it. We polled a recent studio audience and got their best response to this. Donkey blank. Now, the answer they gave most often, remember, is worth $500 if you match it. You match the next one, you get $250, and the third, $100. Whom do you call on over there?
Richard.
Richard.
Donkey Serenade.
La da da, la da da. That's Donkey Serenade is one?
Gary.
Gary. Have you got one?
I've had everyone for the last 6 months, but I haven't got this. All I can think of is donkey cart. Take it or leave it. I'd suggest you leave it.
Donkey
I'm
cart.
I'm sick of this show. I don't want to be on this show anymore.
Donkey cart.
No, that's not bad.
All right. You got another one.
Marianne?
Have you got one, Marianne?
Oh, I was afraid you were going to ask me. I thought of Donkey Serenade, Donkey Cart.
Say Don Quixote.
Still tired.
The obvious donkey ride.
Donkey ride.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's one. Donkey ride, donkey cart, and donkey serenade. And you want one of those, or have you got a better one?
I have nothing. I have no idea, so I'll go with Richard. Donkey serenade.
Donkey serenade. Okay, that's the one she's hoping is up there under the $500 response. But naturally, we've got to start down at the bottom first and reveal the $100 response. Donkey tails.
Sure.
Now that you see it, you all should have thought of it. Did you think of that, Dick?
No, you didn't think of that. The real donkey.
Oh. Yeah. Oh, all right. Looking for Donkey Serenade, here's the $250 response. Donkey cart.
Hey, that wasn't
That's
bad.
That's one that Gary gave you, so that wasn't bad. Gary?
Okay, like the show.
You're going to stay in show business, right? All right. Last chance for the Donkey Serenade. Here is the $500 response. Donkey Serenade.
That's improved.
Yeah. Well, now, Susan, you have $1,200. And again, you're going to try for $5,000. You ready?
I'm ready.
Whom do you try?
Richard.
Richard, okay. One more try with Richard. You all put together?
Yeah.
Okay, fine. $5,000. That's what this is worth. Esther blank. Esther blank. E-S-T-H-E-R blank. Okay, he's finished. Now we call on you for your response, one which you think will match his. What do you say, Esther?
Williams.
Esther Williams. Everybody but two people agrees with you.
Who are they?
Those two in the first row there. I don't know who they are, but they're slowly fading. The audience agrees with her, too, Richard. So for $5,000, we ask you to show and tell. She says Esther Williams will match you.
She probably thought the same as me, Esther Kefauver. But of course, if you don't like senators, you take Williams.
Yeah! $6,200, and while she's shedding a tear of joy, we'll give this message to you. Yes, here we are. Are you ready?
No.
No, yes you are. Well, yeah. You take a deep breath while we welcome our new player. Let's welcome Sherry Ottemeyer. How are you?
Oh, good, good. Thank you.
Where are you from and all that?
I was born and raised in the Valley, and I'm a former stewardess, now married to a wonderful man, and have two hobbies that take up most of my time. I train and show my German Shepherd in breed, ring, and obedience trials, and I have a greenhouse with little green friends in there that I tell all
you
my troubles to.
You talk to your plants?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, I read a book once by a guy who says it really helps the plants.
It
will
does.
Respond. They'll
Except
grow better.
As crazy as I am now.
They are. Oh, we welcome you. Welcome to the zoo.
You're in
Shall
the
we
right
begin?
Side.
Include
All right,
me
Sherry,
out.
Please make a selection.
A, please.
A. Here it is, folks. Everybody knows that Marianne Mobley here was a Miss America. You all aware of that?
1901.
But almost nobody knows that Brett Summers was a Miss Blink.
Just be careful, Dick.
She's sitting next to you.
Remember,
you are lovely.
And we have the rest of the week to go
for. It is for you. Watch it.
And Richard?
Sure. I wasn't going to. Let them be on your hand.
Can you say that?
All right.
I don't know what that means.
Okay, then I won't say it.
Is everybody ready in the lower tier?
No, not yet, because she said that she'd kill me if I said
that. That now.
No, really, it won't match
anything of the kind.
Do your own thing. Everybody on this show does his own thing, right?
Certainly.
Right.
I have help.
Wait a minute.
We're waiting for you, Gary.
I know.
Charles Nelson Reilly is the same way when he's busy. He's really very slow. Yeah.
Never occurred to you that maybe McLean Stevenson wasn't killed in a helicopter? Never occurred to you he may have committed suicide?
Yes, he may have.
Just think it over.
Hello, Sherry. Are you ready for us? Everybody knows, of course, that Marianne Mobley was a Miss America, but almost nobody knows that Brett Summers was a Miss...
Take.
Everybody's in show business but us, eh? Here we are, folks.
That was very good.
Show us yours.
Yeah, it says
show and tell time.
Well, my second choice was misdemeanor.
Misdemeanor. Now, you had the same idea that Sherry had. I'm sorry they don't match
you. She had
the funny one. Yeah. I had a funny one, but I wouldn't put it down.
Warms the cockles of your heart, doesn't he? Brett, what did you say?
I said a misplacement.
A misplacement. Hey, now, is a misplacement a mistake? No. Okay, just checking. Gary?
I'm sorry, my first answer was just too insulting, so I said Miss Alcoholic, 1947.
Miss Alcoholic.
All right. I have children at home who watch this show on the days they're not in school.
Yes.
When they're home drunk.
Want to say it out? You wouldn't let it lie there, would you?
No. Hold everything. Here she is.
Well,
former Miss America.
Yes. You know that I was a has-been Miss America, or am. But what you really didn't know that I was also Miss Livestock Queen.
You were Miss Livestock Queen? I don't get the drift of that, do you?
Yes, I was. Yes. I was Miss Livestock Queen in Forest, Mississippi.
Uh-huh.
And they said, must have been a chunky little rascal. And I said, it was me. And I just thought of who would I like to share the billing with? None other than Brett. So I said, Miss Livestock.
Miss Livestock.
I didn't think it was that funny either, and I'm sorry.
Well, it only took 20 minutes, so I mean, you can't.
Well, if you can't be telling me long.
Richard.
I think it told us a little more about awards than we wish to know. Sherry, that was the hippest answer. Are you really happy? I'm just dying one day for a lady to come out and say, I'm married to a bum.
Yes.
They all come out and say, I'm married to a wonderful person.
Yeah, wouldn't it be refreshing?
Because if she really is married to a guy she doesn't like, we could work together. Mistake.
Oh!
That was great, eh?
Yeah. We're up to Patty Deutsch. Are you up to us?
No, I said a misdemeanor.
Misdemeanor. So we have two misdemeanors and one mistake. All right. So that's one for you, and you stand by. But right now, we've got this for you. Hey. Are you ready, Susan?
Yeah.
Okay. This is your first round question. Let's see how it goes. You know, Walt Disney was a very practical man. Mm-hmm. When Donald Duck became washed up as an actor, Walt made a blank out of him. Walt Disney was a very practical man. When Donald Duck became washed up as an actor, Walt made a blank out of him. Yes, he did. Yeah,
an easy one, honey. I've got it.
Oh, certainly.
Ever.
There are two or three things that come to your mind instantly, like...
What are they?
I can't tell you now, but I'll tell you later.
No, tell me now. Just give me one.
Sure.
Walt Disney, a very practical man. When Donald Duck became washed up as an actor, Walt made a blank out of him.
Chelsea, Beth.
Got the idea.
Lovely hands.
Don't touch me unless you love me.
That's a couple of weeks. You do have lovely hands.
Thank you, Beth.
All right. Okay, slip it in the slot, and away we go, Susan. Walt Disney was a very practical man. When Donald Duck became washed up as an actor, Walt made a blank out of him.
Pillow.
A pillow? She said Walt made a pillow out of him.
Hmm,
interesting idea.
Down.
It's true.
Oh, yeah, the duck down. Duck down. Oh, yes, I had it. Oh, that's right. Yeah. Oh, I see. Yes. Not bad. All right.
That was my
second choice.
Talk about a sellout.
What about this duck, Dick?
That was my second choice.
I said, what about this duck, Dick?
What about this down, Dick? I said made a meal out of it.
Made a meal out of it. Donald Duck Lorange, what do you say?
Oh, sweetheart, he got some nice mashed taters and some yams.
Yes.
And some cranberries, and he made a nice little Thanksgiving dinner.
A rotisserie. Oh. So we have two cooked ducks. Your duck is cooked. Is your duck cooked?
He stuck in his fork and got a meal.
Meal. Well, Susan said when Donald Duck became washed up as an actor, Walt made a pillow out of him. Now, what do you say, Marianne?
That's very good, but how many of you have been to Disneyland lately? Not that many.
Hopefully none of us.
Well, you'll see him walking around, ushering people around. His face fell, so he's an usher at Disneyland.
An usher at Disneyland.
Why does she take so long with her answers?
It's my southern accent.
Can't she just say it and get on with it?
She writes slow also.
You gotta take up for me.
Okay.
I thought it was an improvement over Miss Livestock. Shorter, much crisper.
That's right. Big,
soft end.
Nowhere to open up.
Okay.
Well, if you say it a secret way, the pillow will come back.
Hey! All right.
Yes. Well, if you pluck your duck, then you get a pillow.
A pillow. Okay. So at the end of round one, the score is 2-1 in favor of our current champion. We call on Sherry now to make a selection.
Well, I made such a killing with A, I'll try it again.
A. All right. After 4 years alone on the desert island, Harry was so lonely.
How lonely was he?
I'm glad you asked about old Harry.
He
was so lonely, he spent his afternoons kissing a blank. 4 years alone on the desert island. He was so lonely. He spent his afternoons kissing a blank.
Okay.
Did you see it and laugh at it?
Is there an answer?
Is there something
that's
obvious?
Right. You matched her in the first round.
Is this an obvious one, too?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. 4 years alone. Desert island.
Desert island. So lonely.
So lonely.
How lonely was he?
Every afternoon.
Kissing whatever.
Whatever he kissed.
Is that in the afternoon, sir?
Huh? In the afternoon.
He missed match game.
What is
that's
that?
Right, he did. Well, he
still that, but just
he would have been lonely if he had a tube there to watch match game, because...
I don't know.
Yeah. Nope. I'm on it, and I'm lonely. What are you talking about?
All right. Okay, now we're all set, and we call on Sherry. After 4 years alone on the desert island, Harry was so lonely, he spent his afternoons kissing a...
mirage.
A mirage. You can't go home today?
My husband won't take me back.
Your husband won't take you back after that answer? Listen, you might get lucky with it like you did with the last one. She said,
look at
kissing
some of the answers
a mirage.
I've given.
What do you say?
I thought she was going to go for something a little straighter, so I said, kissing a tree.
Yay! A tree, yeah.
Just to show you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
See, it's show
thank
and
you,
tell.
Yes, it is show and tell.
I'm not sorry. Just tell, see, because it's not that we don't trust you,
no,
Dick.
No,
no, you're an honest guy. I know that. Yeah. All right, now we got to move right along.
I thought their act was just make believe. Little did I know.
That's the way it is. What he's put up with.
I said kissing a palm tree.
A palm tree. Mirage is what she's looking for.
He was kissing always out of the side of his mouth because what he was kissing was walking sideways. I said a crab.
A crab. All right. right, that's all right. Now, we're running a little behind time, so...
he had chapped lips from kissing a palm tree.
A palm tree. Okay, you have to match Patty to stay in the game. Let's see what you've got, Patty. She's looking for Mirage.
Oh, I said that he was kissing his Friday.
His Friday. So, Susan wins the game. Congratulations. You've done it again. Now, Sherry, we thank you for being with us.
Oh, it was my pleasure meeting you. I really had a good time.
Good. Sherry Ottemeyer. There she goes. And now while we spin her off, we'll spin this commercial for you. Thank you all. Gene Rayburn, Match Game 75. Join us next time. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 75. A Mark Goodson, Bill Tubman production.